Whoa. We got a baby.
Baby.
So it's a rash. This one is a puzzle to the parent. So we'll go see if we can figure it out.
Is it a puzzle to you?
I had to think.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hi.
How's it going? A cute baby. Hi.
How you doing?
How you doing? All right. So, you've got a rash you wanted me to look at.
Yes, on the back of his leg.
How long has it been here?
About 5 days.
Okay. And this is the first time it's happened?
Yes.
All right. So, I am seeing it in these creases. Now we got yourself a chunky guy, huh? Are you a chunky guy?
Hi.
Are you breastfeeding?
Yes.
Yeah, that usually explains all them rolls. Good breastfed baby. Yes, yes, yes. So, the rash is mostly in the creases. You can see when we close those legs, it disappears. And it's a little red around the edges, a little sparing in the middle. It's on both sides. There's almost the appearance of a kind of a bruise here in the middle.
Oh, you don't like your legs stretched, huh? You don't like your legs stretched? No, you don't. Hi. How you doing? How you doing? What you see there?
You like the camera. This is a future star here. I think so. Definitely going to be a star.
Sure.
Yep.
Sure.
Sure.
Just tell me what's wrong.
Yeah, tell me.
All right. So, a couple thoughts I have. Well, let's peek at the anticubes here of the elbows.
They what?
Anticubes. That's what they call it. Anticubical. I don't know if that's what it's called or not. Anticube. I don't know. I'm just a doctor. Here's the other side. These look good, right? So, if it was eczema, that's real common in the creases. Right here on the elbows, behind the knees, right here. So could this be very early presentation for eczema? I sort of doubt it, just because there's no involvement of the arms, but maybe. And so then what is it? Well, yeast, and look at this here. So where the diaper hits, and we're not gonna take the diaper off because we actually just changed the diaper, but you can see some redness kind of right where the diaper hits, and a little blueness where this has gotten irritated here. Same was on this side. His buttocks area was fine, so there was nothing there. And what I was gonna say, you wanna help me, huh? Yeast likes creases, so could this be a yeast rash? If there were more little dots around the edges, we call them satellite lesions, that could be yeast. Yeast that's only in the bottom part of your body, not involving anywhere else, it would have to come from the bottom. And I've already, when he was getting his diaper changed, there's nothing going on here. I mean, the anus is normal, perianal area is normal. So I don't think it's yeast for that reason, or we would have problems down here on his buttocks, right around his anus. So okay. I think we've just got the fact that you got moisture trapped in these creases, and moisture can be very irritating to the skin, basically. He's got very sensitive skin. So our first approach here, we're gonna call it a contact dermatitis, basically from the moisture. We're gonna try, whee! Hi, I got a little too feisty with you, huh? Oh, okay, there you go. Oops! Oh, now I went and did it, I'm sorry. You know, I'm going and done it now, huh? Oh, look, is that your brother? Yeah. Okay. Mommy got two arms?
I know.
That's a super mom for you. Okay, so we're gonna try some barrier creams. We're gonna try air drying it and letting it. Oh, honey, it's here. Can we trade? Can you come with me?
Oh, yay!
Yay! Oh, I can handle you better. How are you doing? You good? Are you good?
Too much.
Are you good? So we're gonna try air drying this. We're gonna try barrier creams, natural oils like coconut oil or olive oil. See if that just allows the skin underneath to heal. And my guess is that's all that's required. If both of those things fail, maybe we'll try a little antifungal just in case there is a little yeast in those creases. Mm-hmm. Yeast likes warm, moist places. So that's another possibility. Nothing serious here. This is just a new thing in the last 5 days. If it becomes chronic, we start thinking about foods, eczema, go down that path.
Okay. How long do you expect it to take for it to clear up with the...
Well, if we get it all right, we keep it dry or the bear creams work, the redness will go away within the next week or so.
Okay.
1 to 2 weeks. Mm-hmm. We might be left with slight discoloration, just almost like how a bruise resolves.
Okay.
Because with all that redness, that means extra blood flow in the area. Some of the red blood cells break apart and release pigment that just sort of leaves the area discolored,
okay,
like a bruise.
Yeah.
But within 2 to 4 weeks, it should look totally normal if we get it right.
Okay.
Yeah, because he's so chunky and those areas are going to be moist, my hunch is it'll come and go.
Mm-hmm.
It's going to be really hard to keep that area completely dry all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What do you think? You think that sound good? Want to say hi to your fans on YouTube? Say bye.
Mm-hmm. Lucas?
Is that you? Is that you? Is that you? He's looking. Is that you? Who's that? Who's that? There. Oh, there's Mama.
Whoa.
There she is. All right. You guys, thanks for watching. Simple contact dermatitis rash, we hope. Go away with a little bit of care, dryness, and keeping it dry, and maybe a barrier cream. I'm Dr. Paul. Thanks for watching. Bye, little man.
Bye.